So in this experiment, we're going to look at trends in solubilities of carboxylic acids. So in these micro test tubes here, we have just got some water. Into each of the test tubes, I'm going to add, firstly, methanoic acid to the first test tube, ethanoic acid to the second test tube, propanoic acid to the third test tube, and finally butanoic acid to the final test tube. And we're looking to see if we can see a trend in the solubility of these carboxylic acids. So if I start with methanoic acid, I'm going to add that in there, and I can give it a little shake, and you can see there that methanoic acid is completely soluble in water. Okay, so next I'm going to go to ethanoic acid, which has got that smell that you'll recognise as vinegar. And if we take some ethanoic acid and add it to the water, you can see that it goes a bit cloudy. If I give it a bit of a shake and then leave it, that cloudiness will disappear as the ethanoic acid becomes completely soluble in the water. If I now go into propanoic acid, and we add some propanoic acid to the water, you can probably see in the camera there that it's becoming less miscible. Okay, there's bubbles of the kind of propanoic acid there. It looks like bubbles, it's actually bubbles of the liquid as it's becoming less miscible in the water. And finally, to get the lid off butanoic acid, has a very characteristic smell, very not unlike vomit, and we'll add some butanoic acid to the water. And I'll quickly return the lid to the butanoic acid. And you can probably see there that the butanoic acid is sitting as a layer on top of the water. Okay, it's insoluble in water. Okay, so if I move these out of the way so that we can have another little look at them in front of the camera, the methanoic acid there, you can see, has completely dissolved in the water. The ethanoic acid, you can see the cloudiness has disappeared and it's become completely miscible in the water. Ethanoic acid is also soluble in water. Propanoic acid has started to become miscible with the water, but it's less soluble, clearly less soluble than the methanoic and ethanoic acids. And finally, the butanoic acid there is sitting as an extra layer there. I don't know if it makes it easier to see if I put it in front of my hand. You can see that it's sitting as a layer on top of the water as it's insoluble. So as our carboxylic acids go from methanoic, ethanoic, propanoic and butanoic acid, as that carbon chain length increases, the solubility in water decreases.